Welcome back, boys and girls, to episode 40 of the Nerd Chills podcast, or the Midlife Crisis episode. This is Adam Diaz, and with me, as always, is CJ. Welcome back, CJ.
Hi. It kind of fits perfectly for this short week we're having.
Indeed it does. In fact, we're going to be having a relatively short time between episodes. We usually go 6 or 7 days between recording, and it's only been 3. Because some of us are going to be out of town, but we want to make sure we had your pod fixed for you. So
we just couldn't stay away.
We couldn't. So sitting in the third chair, obviously, is Charlie. Welcome back, Charlie.
Oh, hey, that's me.
Oh, yes, it is. And in the fourth chair, yet again, is Robin Grace. Welcome back, Robin.
Hello.
Hello. So it's probably going to be a relatively short episode. Not a ton of news. It's Wednesday, so we've literally had 2 days of news. But there is some stuff in there. There's a lot of PlayStation news. And then for the main topic of the show, we're all going to pick... As of October 4th, because that's today, I think. Yeah, as of October 4th, what our game of the year would be. That way, at the end of the year, when we revisit it, we can see how much the last 2 months of the year have an effect. So it'll be kind of fun. But starting out, I'm going to go with Charlie because you're looking at me. What's up?
Should we do that thing that we talked about?
Which thing?
The thing about the stuff in the place that we live in.
Oh, yeah. So I guess we should probably just... address that. Charlie, Robin, and I all live in Las Vegas, as we've said in the past, so this Sunday was a pretty traumatic event for a lot of people, and it's kind of surreal. I went to work Monday, and everyone was kind of talking about the shooting, and it was very eerily reminiscent for me of September 11th, because everyone knew someone who was there, or the person that sits 3 rows down from you had a story, and everyone was talking about where they were when it happened, and they're telling us if you want to take time off, you can. If you need therapy, you have it. And they set up like therapy sessions at my work today. They had a blood drive come out, and they said that if you're going to go donate blood, that you we're going to expect to wait 8 hours. And all the blood banks were asking for people to bring cookies and salty snacks and bottled water because they've run out. So it was... Wow. Kind of incredible. It was really worrisome. It was crazy because Saturday night after we recorded, we played games, and then Sunday we went over to Charlie's sister's house and we had a game night, and it was super fun. We all had a blast, and then we all went home, and then you turn on the TV and see something like that happen, and it's like, I'm pretty sure no one I know is there. But
yeah,
like,
and then you get a million of phone calls. And then you get a million phone calls from, like, your family and your friends that are freaking out.
Yeah, asking you what happened and how you are. And, like, it was just, it was really fucking crazy. And I messaged Charlie and I was like, I'm pretty sure you didn't take a detour to go to the Strip because we were on the other side of town. But at the same time, like, you really just never fucking know. So, like, from your end, Charlie, like, what was Monday morning like?
I think that, like you said, I don't know anybody, but I know people that knew people. You know, people that were injured, people that were there, people that left right before. I've had customers. One of my coworkers, her husband works in security at the Luxor. So it's just, I feel like it's weird because you would think that that kind of event wouldn't be so appealing to locals, but everyone I know somebody who was in some way, shape, or form affected.
Yeah, it was... It was intense. What about you, Robin? How was it like for you on Monday?
It was just like going to school was not even an option for so many people because school is literally, what, five
miles away?
Yeah, it's so close. You could literally see the two windows that were shot out from the parking lot. It's crazy. And then my uncle also works for Las Vegas Metro Police Department, so he was like... I was there all night, like, with the security and dealing with all that stuff, and it's just crazy.
Yeah, it's so crazy. It's really intense, and to anyone who was affected, because we do have a lot, we all live in Las Vegas except for CJ, and a lot of people that we know here listen, so anyone who's affected, like, it's kind of cheap to say your thoughts and prayers with someone because you don't know them, but realistically, our hearts go out to you guys, and it's a terrible thing, and it really sucks, and everyone has a million stories. I just heard a million stories at work of all these different things, and it kind of puts things in perspective. So We hope our podcast brings you guys a little bit of levity and a little bit of information on something that you do enjoy as a hobby, and we enjoy doing it for you guys. So to those of you who were affected, or whether or not you were directly affected, we're here for you guys. And if you want to email us, regardless of what it's about, I had people I've never talked to at work just walk up to me and just start talking about it because people need someone to talk to. I know Robin had someone at the mall I work at, which is actually, no, it wasn't even the mall I work at. It was just a different strip mall, who was just checking her out of some place she went to buy something. Just bring it up. Like, it just came pouring out of her.
Oh, yeah, and she was like, three of my friends died. I was like, holy crap. Like, it's real. People that think this is not a big deal, it's a big deal.
Like, yeah. Monday was crazy because I got to work, and it was, like, normal. Like, the guy who sits next to me was like, hey, what's up, man? And we, like, so do you know anyone that got hurt? And then he's like, yeah, I know a couple people. And I was like, I know a couple friends who have friends who were there. And then our boss walked by us. He's like, hey, just so you know, Joe, who sits three desks away from me, like, he's not going to be in today. He's okay, but he gave his tickets to that concert away, and both of his friends died.
Oh my god.
So, like, when I saw him, he came in, he just started crying. I'm like, holy shit, like, this is fucking crazy. Like, it really is. So
yeah, wow,
it's just one of those things where it just blows your goddamn mind. So just want to say, you know, it's been a rough week for pretty much everybody, and you think everything's just normal, and then you talk to someone, you're like, wow, like, I did not realize how awful things are for the person standing right next to me. So take care of each other.
Yeah, that's
really all you can really say about it.
Don't take anything for granted, for sure.
Yeah, never. So but on that sad note, we won't really do a moment of silence because silence really isn't our thing. But we did want to go ahead and just mention it because we are citizens of Vegas, and even CJ lived in Vegas, you know, for a portion of his life too, so
for a while.
It all kind of hits home for all of us. But getting on to the normal stuff, CJ, what have you been playing for the last 2.5 days since we last talked?
All the same stuff as last time. So PUBG, League of Legends, Call of Duty, Destiny. But I added in the Fortnite Battle Royale.
Nice, I did too.
Which is super fun. It's a blast.
And it's free, so, like I said.
And it's free, which is real nice. But just being able to... Like, it's still a traditional battle royale, but once you get into a gunfight with someone, you just start building a fortress at your feet, or the sky towers that you see people make with staircases leading all the way up. And,
right.
Probably my best story is I was trying to build a staircase to get from one mountain to another because one of the mountains was in the safe zone. And as I'm running across, I start hearing gunshots. So I'm trying to, like, just move as quick as I can. And then all of a sudden, the floor just falls out from beneath me, and I fall, and I just... crash to the ground and die. It was rough. It was rough.
That's epic. My first game, I waited forever to jump out of the plane. I landed next to some guy who was just, like, taking stuff down so that he could, like, start building stuff. And, like, I guess we just had this silent agreement, like, let's not kill each other, let's build stuff. So we started doing it, and then, like, 5 minutes later, when we both had houses, like, we were standing next to each other, and some dude just turned the corner and, like, looked at both of us, and we're like, oh yeah, this is a battle arena. And then he just brutally defeated us. I was like, that was fucking ridiculous. So it was fun though. It was really fun. Right on, bro. So Charlie, what have you been playing these last 2 days?
I have not played anything other than the board games we played. We played Battlestar Galactica, which was super cool.
I really enjoyed it. We were looking at that game when we started, like, what the fuck is this?
I know,
this?
And it was pretty intense at first, but yeah. It was cool. I won both times. My group won.
Samesies. High five.
Go
over Robin's mic.
Humans and Cylons.
Oh, fuck you.
We Eiffel Towered the microphone.
I fucking hate you guys.
Eiffel Towered.
We played Pandemic for the first time ever. Andy's owned that for a while, and we finally sat down and played it. And that was super fun, although I'm not
that
sure.
That was very easy. It was
felt
too easy.
Yeah, I feel like maybe we're not doing what we're supposed to be doing. Yeah,
something's wrong there. It was way too easy.
We played a little bit of that Harry Potter battle card game, deck builder.
Game is hard.
That game was fun. It got pretty hard towards the middle.
Is Voldemort actually in that game?
Yeah. Wow. Well, sort of. He's
just one of the enemies.
He's one of the enemies that you battle. I mean, it's not like a super, super serious battle guy.
His name is Voldemort.
That's pretty much all I played. I don't think I've touched a video game. I've just been watching TV and working my life away.
Right, samesies. Yeah. Robin, aside from losing at Battlestar Galactica,
Fuck you and you Cylon bastards.
Hey, we were human the first time.
It's kind of funny because it's not even her fault. We actually read the rules incorrectly and added in one too many traitor cards, which meant that of the...
Five
of the six people that were playing wound up being traitors, and Robin was the only human. And
she ended up in the brig.
Oh my god.
We locked her in the brig and blew the fucking ship up. It was kind of funny. But it was not unfair. It was not fair at all. But aside from that, Robin, what have you been playing?
Fallout 4. All I've been playing is Fallout 4. Like, that's about it.
Watching you build in Fallout 4 was what reminded me, like, oh, you should try and see if Fortnite is actually free or not. So
yeah, I really like the... Since I bought the expansion, I like the world creation in Fallout, so getting to build ridiculous leveled houses.
Your houses are ridiculous. I've not seen anyone spend as much time building out settlements. Like, your neighborhoods look nicer than some neighborhoods I've been to in real life.
Oh my god.
In the post-apocalyptic world of Fallout, so. Right on. Is that about it for you?
Yeah, Fallout 4 and Fallout Shelter. That's my life.
Right on. I played...
Pokemon Go, but you know.
Pokemon Go, yeah. We got our bikes all set up. We got our phone mounts. We can start exercising and really just playing Pokemon Go.
Have you been doing any of the new stuff? Because I haven't touched it since, like, raids started.
Like, those raids?
Or have you been catching anything new?
Well, I caught a Chansey. That's new.
Oh, cool.
But with the raids, it's like all the Pokemon that show up for raids require... Oh my god, that scared me. All the Pokemon that show up for raids require, like, at least 10 people.
Yeah.
They're tough.
Yeah, and there's no way you're going to beat it by yourself. So, I don't know. I haven't participated.
We kind of did. We fought one a little bit, and then
that's
we're like,
that's where we
was
found
fun.
Out it's impossible alone.
Yeah, it was Legendary Dog or something.
I'm down with, like, you have to get out there and do stuff. I just hate the concept of having to interact with people, even if I don't have to know them or talk to them. Right. I hate the idea of having to group up.
Meet strangers and be friendly.
I'm not
in it for that either.
It's really irritating when all the legendary Pokemon require you to have to work with other people, because otherwise you'll never get one. Like, it's stupid.
I'll never get one.
That's why I quit playing, because I'm like, super loner Pokemon Go player.
Yeah, all I plan on doing is catching Pokemon, gathering the Stardust, and then getting a bunch of eggs and using my bike to hatch eggs. You get a walk around on campus on UNLV, so it's a little bit easier. But right on. For me, I actually played a game of NBA 2K. Charlie was nice enough to give me her copy. And I gotta say, I understand why people get addicted to it, because it's basketball and it's fast-paced and it's fun. However, I will say it's also bullshit. Because I picked the Cavaliers, and I played...
It's very bullshit.
The worst team was, with the worst ratings. And every time we were tied, all of a sudden, like, they could shoot from anywhere on the fucking court, like, 10 feet behind the three-point with my hand in their face, and they literally would score 15 points in a row, and then it's like the game reactivated into, like, actual simulation mode and not bullshit mode. And after four quarters, I was tied... And I came out and I was like, if they make five three-pointers in a row again, I quit. And it literally happened. I was like, I'm down by 15 again, so I guess I'm just going to play something else.
Did you try using LeBron or...
I did try using Bron.
Or what's his name?
Steph Curry. No, I didn't go back for a second one. I played
not
with LeBron.
Not Steph or Bron. No. Bron. That's why you failed.
Bron.
So I was like, I'm not going to get addicted to this, so played that, and then...
it's a rough game.
Played Fortnite, and I actually really liked Fortnite. I was like, now that I've played this, and I might actually want to go buy the full game now, because it was cool that I could just download it and play the Battle Arena against 100 other people. So that's about it for me, though. Aside from that, I watched a movie called 13 Demons on Netflix last night.
It was horrible.
It might be the worst horror movie I've ever seen.
It's not even a horror movie. It's a waste of time movie.
I've seen Attack of the Killer Tomatoes, and that's a fucking god-awful movie.
At least that has a catchy song.
The best part about it was rated 5 stars. Like, people have been watching it going, that was horrible, let's rate it really high.
That's not how Netflix works.
That's what everyone tells me, but...
It means you guys watch crappy horror, and you must like it.
That's Robin who watches crappy horror.
See?
I remember back on Netflix they had a movie called Rubber. It was about a psychic tire that could blow people's
heads. I remember that fucking movie. That had more of a plot. This movie is just a premise of, hey, what if a board game could make you go crazy.
Like it was Jumanji? Like, it was like an intense
game. They literally referenced Jumanji in right. the first 5 minutes.
But it was like an intense game of D&D where you have your characters and you're these paladins that have to go through this story.
And you guys didn't like that?
And
right? How could we not like this?
It was horrible. It was like they got so into the game, they started murdering people because they thought that the people were the demons in the game. That
yeah, it's not nearly as cool as that premise is.
Oh my god.
It's so boring though, because the first time they start to play the game, it's like, you can tell it's all improv. Like, they didn't have a fucking script, they just had a general idea and some props. It's like almost all filmed in one location.
That's what I do when I have a few things lying around. I'm like, we could make a movie out of this.
We could literally make a movie in a day better than that fucking movie. And
I
like,
could make a movie.
It was just, oh my god. It was not good.
Are you proposing Nerd Chills the movie?
Oh my
not
god.
Quite yet, but maybe.
Yeah, we just gotta get some emojis and some
Lego people.
It's true. Lego, yeah, we'll just make it Lego people. And just do animation. That works.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's what I've been watching. I don't think I've watched anything else except for news coverage, to be honest with you. And like, that was the, I don't know. I was like, news coverage, I need to watch something else. And I was like, I'll turn the fucking news coverage back on. This movie was garbage. So, Robin, is there anything else you've been watching besides that?
I've been watching One Punch Man again.
I like that you didn't want to watch One Punch Man. I made us watch the first episode. Now you've watched like 5 more episodes than I have.
It's so good.
I'm still refusing to watch it.
It's so good. Like, you need to watch it. It's worth watching.
Nope.
I think you'd like it if you saw it too, CJ. It's a shame.
I know I will, but I don't want to give in.
All right. Charlie, what have you been watching?
So seriously, it's been 2 days. Yesterday was Tuesday. I'm trying to think. Monday when I got home from work, I watched Portlandia and went to bed. And then yesterday I watched Portlandia. And then I got into a giant YouTube hole. One of my friends sent me a link to a YouTube of a Tiny Desk concert, because NPR does Tiny Desk concerts. And that? I'll usually... It's just a performer doing a live performance at a really, just in their desk area, like a cubicle almost.
That's hilarious.
And I usually catch them like through the week, but I watched that one and then I just started watching like all these videos. So I spent literally, I think, 3 hours watching.
Wow.
Like Tiny Desk, and then I just went into like live videos of some of my favorite people, and it got into a serious thing, and before I knew it, it was like midnight. So that's what I've been watching.
Nice. CJ, what are you watching? Did you find a show hole yourself?
No, I mean I'm about to. I watched the first episode of Black Clover because that's finally out.
Oh, isn't it good?
It's
like Naruto, kind of.
It reminds me a little bit of Naruto and what's that? Full Metal Alchemist.
Yeah.
So far it's been pretty good. It's pretty strong. The first episode was good. Here towards the middle it gets a little redundant, but it has a strong finish.
Every
and people
series
are already
has
excited.
To have filler.
Yeah.
That just happened.
And then people are already excited for another season, so we'll see where it goes from there. And I hope I'll have a chance to finish it all by the end of the week.
I nice. Just read the manga. I've never seen the actual anime. I don't know.
I haven't done either, so maybe I'll check out the anime. Right on. Is that about it? I mean, I know it's only been 2 days, so.
Besides staring at a computer screen playing games, I mean, I can't really count watching it if I'm playing it, but if you want to, I can say what I'm watching.
Sure, go for it. I mean, shout out to streamers if you're watching it.
I've been watching a lot of Ninja, who is a pro Halo player playing Fortnite and PUBG. He was the one that kind of gave me some of the ideas that got me my first couple wins in Fortnite with how to build correctly and what to do in the early game. Because you can go, even though the map is pretty big, the gliding system in that game, you can get from one side to the other no problem. So there's really no like, all right, I'm going to go all the way out here and extend myself and make sure no one's around me. Like, once you hit the ground, prepare to land. So you might as well just start out. As soon as you can drop, just drop and hit the ground, find something and survive. It's a lot easier that way than stretching out to either side of the map.
That's actually really good to know, because I went to like the other side of the map. I was on the plane forever, and that's probably why I got destroyed as soon as I saw another human being who wasn't friendly, because he actually had gear and all I had was a fancy house that I had built. So,
because you could wait. So like you could wait to the very end just to get to like the back side of the map, and I could jump at the very beginning and beat you to the back side of the map because I already jumped. Like it's kind of crazy.
That is crazy.
So I think as the game goes on, I think they might change how far you can glide and stuff, which will help. But as of right now, as soon as you see jump, jump and find somewhere to land and start killing shit.
Nice. Right on. Cool. So I think that covers it pretty well. So we can just move into the big three. There's not a whole lot of news. I know there's no Nintendo news that I found except a Sony article. Charlie accidentally
put one in there. No, I put one in there. I put a real one in there.
Oh, okay, cool. But yeah, we'll start out with Microsoft. So CJ, take it away.
I have a whole lot of one article today. and it's comes with a grain of salt. So if you go back and you go to your local GameStop or local game store and you purchase the whatever edition of Destiny that comes with all three expansions, can't remember what it's called, you will actually now, as of a couple days ago, be able to finally fully access everything Destiny 1 has to offer, because all the timed release content is finally up. So you get all the, you'll have all the guns that PlayStation did, you'll have all the extra strikes, all the extra multiplayer maps.
You only had to wait about 3 years since the original release.
Yeah, 2.5-3 years.
I got a little confused for a minute. I thought you were saying they were making the DLC free.
Oh, no, no, no.
They should totally do that. No,
they're still going to have
you buy it. They should do that so that people would actually get into it. But, yeah, that whole timed exclusivity thing has finally expired. Yeah.
Oh, good.
It took 36 months for Xbox players to be able to. So I'll see you
3 years from now.
What was all the complaining about? Right? It's ready now.
Yeah, since Destiny 2's out, now people can go back and play Destiny 1 shit.
We're sharing now.
I hate you.
See, I think that's how they're going to make it last 10 years. It's really only going to last 5.
But it'll be 10 for fucking Xbox users.
Yeah, it'll be 10 together combined between PlayStation and Xbox.
Yeah, that's a good point. I like that. That makes a whole lot of sense from Bungie's perspective.
I think you guys can... Yeah, I was going to say, I think you guys should really appreciate that great relationship that Microsoft has with Bungie. That's what's caused this.
They're just classic for pissing in people's faces, so maybe they'll do something nice. Or maybe Bungie will enjoy the golden showers in the future. So, right on. Solid Microsoft news, I gotta say, CJ. You fucking nailed it. We're gonna move ahead to Sony news. There's actually a lot of Sony news, so Charlie, go for it.
And a lot of it I have not exactly checked out, so I'm gonna be doing it with you guys.
So, meanwhile, I was swamped going over this one extensive article. You weren't doing shit.
Yeah, I know. I'm really ashamed of myself. I don't know what I've become. That's all right.
I don't know what I've become.
But the first article I have is about the PlayStation VR. I guess they are revamping the design of the PSVR, which I think is a good idea. It kind of annoys me because I already have the PSVR and I will not buy a new one.
Cash grab.
But mine was free, so I can't complain. But apparently they're changing some really good... they're making some good design feature changes, and they're integrating the stereo headset cable and an updated processor. So it seems like they're making some good changes. Maybe it'll be capable of more, and maybe it won't be as quite as clunky with all the cables and whatnot.
It is really cumbersome, especially if you're trying to use, like, the headset I have on right now is a Sony headset, and it's really good using it with the VR, but, like, it barely, like, reaches and it barely fits, so.
And I'm getting the impression that this is, like, Sony tends to do this. It's priced at the standard price of the VR. So just like with the Slim, Sony just kind of quietly changes things and they don't charge you more or try to release a new model, which I always appreciate.
Are they going to call it VR Headset Pro?
No, it's just going to still be PlayStation VR, and anyone that buys it from the time that they start making the new model will get the new model, and that's it. Like, they don't distinguish between them because they do the same stuff. They're just making a couple tweaks. Yeah, they're not going to charge you for that upgrade.
That's cool.
Yeah. Like how Xbox 360 back in the day changed their power brick like 17 times.
Yeah. Oh.
Yep.
I mean, they just, like I said, with the Slim came out and it was like, they just showed up in store one day. No one knew and no one was like, yeah, I got to get that Slim model. Like, right. They're just like, now we make them this way. So they just change it and go forward. But my next piece of news has to do with the 5.0 firmware update.
Oh, snap.
For PS4. And once again, I know nothing about it, so I'm looking here.
I did see that they're changing the way that you can actually make groups of your friends, so you can send out invites to specific
groups. People I hate and people I talk to sometimes.
Why would you have them on your friends list if they're people you hate?
Don't we all have that?
Yeah.
They're called customer. No, just kidding.
That's fine. Realistically, it's like, this is my Destiny fire team, so you can message all of them at once, like, and send them a party invite rather than going through and message, like, how happy you are with yourself. You're even turning red because of how real that statement was. I still have customers from my Arizona store on my thing, and I'll scroll through, and I'm like, Yeah, I remember this guy. I didn't hire him.
I don't even play multiplayer, truth be told.
I don't. You worked at GameStop as a manager in Hawaii like 7 years ago, mm-hmm. and you still have your customers on your mm-hmm. your thing. So yeah, it makes it easier for you to message them, for you to invite them in game, and for you to group your friends together. And then there's just stuff in there. Yeah, they made it a lot more like the Xbox 360 interface used to be, except they actually added groups, which sounds like a really good idea.
It looks like they're improving family controls as well. You can have up to 7 family members in your, like, family account. They're making that a lot more user-friendly. As you said, they're building on some community-based stuff. So nothing insane, but some good tweaks, I'm sure. And then my next piece of Sony news. Sorry, I'm, like, still struggling through this. There are games on sale? Is that what this says? Oh, God. Some of Sony's best... we actually had some of these go on sale as well in the store. Lost Legacy is down to $30 already. That game is really good. I've also heard it's terribly, terribly short. So if you're...
I thought you were going to say, it's really good. I've also heard it's terribly, terribly bad. I was like, okay.
That's where it sounded like it was going.
It's a mix.
I know.
It's had mixed reviews.
But yeah, I had people that, you know... were really, really excited about it and then got it and they're like, it was great, but I beat it in like 5 hours and it has really similar gameplay to Uncharted 4 and the whole series. So not exactly reinventing the wheel. If you've been thinking about picking it up, you're saving 25%. Nier Automata is coming out. It's on sale. It's only $40. And that's a pretty good deal because I heard really good things about that game. Yeah, that is one of those games. I've heard
great things about that one.
That could be a Game of the Year contender, at least in some categories. I don't think it's popular enough or gained enough traction to be Game of the Year.
See, this is always happens is that a game like Nier will come out the same year as a game like Neo will come out, where they're like different and sound the exact same, and I get them confused constantly.
At least Overwatch and Battleborn were like similar looking.
Right.
But yeah, did Neo come out this year?
Pretty sure Neo came out in March. Yeah, Neo did come out like right this after. I think it was
this year. There are a bunch of other PS4 games, PS3 games, some Vita games. So go and check out that stuff if you are playing on a Sony console. And as far as the stuff that I know a little bit more about, because I actually put it in here myself, so proud. Horizon Zero Dawn. They announced that there's going to be a complete edition for it. I don't know why they didn't just wait, because it's going to, like, probably win Game of the Year. Guys,
remind
come
me
on.
What Horizon Zero Dawn is again.
It's a game you own. It's for that other console that you have.
Oh, the one with the robot dinosaurs.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Oh, Ark?
Are they robots in Ark?
I don't know.
I don't think they're real dinosaurs.
They are. Yeah, there's a robot T-Rex game.
Never mind. So, they're making a complete edition, which will include the DLC. It comes out December 5th, and it's going to be $50, which is really cool. I'm even kind of, if it wasn't so far away, I would consider trading my copy, but I know I'm going to want to play the DLC, like, first thing. Even though I haven't finished the game, I just keep looking at the calendar, like,
I can't wait to pass you so I can talk shit to you.
I know, I thought about that the other day.
What's taking so long, Charlie?
I was like, oh my god, he's going to beat it fast, because, like, you beat Shadow of Mordor, and I know that game's not terribly long, but I was like, he beat a game? I can't do that.
That happens. Like, I was funny. I was sitting on the couch. I was like, I haven't beat something since Legend of Zelda. And before that, I don't remember the last game I beat.
Yeah.
So, 2 in 1 year, killing it.
I don't think I've ever really beat a game other than Kingdom Hearts.
I don't know. I've seen you play a lot of Hatsune Miku, so.
Oh. Yeah.
I've snapped a disc in half. Does that count as beating the game?
In some circles?
That might be the last game I beat. Hatsune Miku for Vita. I played the shit out of that.
What about Overcooked? Did you guys beat Overcooked?
We did beat Overcooked.
Oh, we did beat Overcooked.
We 100%ed Overcooked. We beat the shit out of Overcooked.
I have not yet. Boom. I need a new partner for Overcooked. Hey,
that'll
Robin Montiers.
Robin's played it all the way through.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. That's so cool. So yeah, if you haven't played that game and you haven't had a really good friend buy it for you out of the kindness of her heart
on your birthday
for possibly a special occasion, then you can go out and buy it on December 5th with all the DLC.
Or you can have your friend who hasn't done that for you yet get it for you for
Christmas.
Christmas
is coming, yeah.
Yep, so you can disappoint your friends. True. It's a good time.
What the fuck?
My last bit of PlayStation news is that they are getting a new CEO over at Sony Entertainment. Sony Interactive Entertainment. Andrew House is stepping down. He's going to be he's going to be on the board, I think, until the end of the year. But he is immediately being replaced by John Codera.
Wow.
Godzilla.
I just like to pronounce it that way. It's probably like Codera. I don't know. It's like K-O-D-E-R-A. But it's like immediate.
Cotera. Yeah, I thought Cotera too.
He's been with the company for a really long time, so it's kind of crazy. But I hope that the next person can continue to be successful in that position. It doesn't seem like he's done anything that's made him want to step away from it per se.
I think it's always really funny when people say, like, they've been with the company forever and they work their way up from the bottom. It's like, I've watched people get hired in from the bottom, and, like, you're told right away, like, we're just doing this so he can learn what the business is like. We're going to promote him, like, as soon as he knows what's going on. And then they use that, like, success story. Like, this guy worked his way up to the top, when it's like, you hired him in with the intention of making him an executive within 12 months. Like, don't fucking do that. So I wonder if it's an actual success story or if it's one of those manufactured ones.
Time will tell.
Indeed.
And that is all my Sony news.
Cool. I only have one Nintendo article, and it's one that Charlie just gave me. It is something I had heard about, though, and this is actually very Nintendo. Amazon is one of the few locations where people are still, like, desperately struggling to get their pre-order met for the SNES Classic. That was the other thing I forgot to mention, is that I played a lot of SNES Classic with Wade.
Oh, yeah, you did.
When you guys were playing the four-player games, we went over, and I got to play Contra 3 Alien Wars again, and it's so much fun, and it's so goddamn hard.
Let me just say that as an observer, I thought it was hilarious when you guys had to pull up chairs to the television because you were like 5 feet away.
Too fucking short again.
And then you were talking about how it was hurting your eyes to play Mario Kart because it's so pixelated. Like, that shit made me laugh.
I was like, how in the fuck did I do this as a kid?
But you guys played like every game on there, damn near, it looked like.
We cycled through like everything that we had both played, and I think then Wade played a few things. Dude, I lay down to watch him play Mega Man. He's fucking good at Mega Man.
I know.
He like almost beat the game, and I was like, Landon, I'm like, you like my personal Twitch. And I started getting like really sleepy because I love to nap while I watch Twitch. And then he's like, do you want to play Contra? I was like, fuck yeah. So that was really fun. But anyways.
I loved hearing the commentary about the games, like, graphics are amazing,
right? They really stretched this 16-bit. It's funny though, because when you see a company like Nintendo release something like Yoshi's Island versus some of the other games that are on there, and you can kind of see how the environments Yoshi's and all the characters were
really good.
Yoshi's Island looked fucking great. I was like, holy shit, this game totally holds up. And like watching Wade play it, I was like, I want to fucking play this game. This game looks really fun too, versus when we were playing like Ghouls and Goblins or whatever that game was. I was like, this game looks like shit. It's super fucking hard. Let's play something else. Like, it was not fun. But a lot of people on Amazon still haven't had their pre-orders filled for their SNES Classic. So there's always a Nintendo nightmare somewhere. What's really funny is so many people have reached out to Amazon Help and said, like, hey guys, I haven't gotten my fucking SNES Classic yet. What's going on? They keep saying that there's issues filling stock because they didn't get enough. But then also people are tweeting and posting on Instagram of Amazon's treasure trucks that they have that just kind of roll out in like major markets. And they're fucking filled with SNES Classics for people to just walk up and buy.
They did the same thing with the Switch. There were people that were waiting for their Switches that they had pre-ordered because they had like 2-day shipping. And it was on Amazon Prime Now. So people were getting it. People were just ordering it and getting it in 2 hours delivered to them. When people that pre-ordered had to at least wait 2 days.
For anyone who wants a really good story where people get really pissed at each other, listen to IGN's Nintendo podcast, Nintendo Voice Chat. Because the day after the Switch launched, or the week of the Switch launch, they had that happen. And two of the guys were like, I'm still waiting for my pre-order on Amazon. And then one of the guys sitting there like, you didn't pre-order yours, did you? You're never going to get one. He's like, actually, I Amazon Prime-nowed it, and it got here an hour ago.
Oh,
and they
God.
Lost their shit. It was so fucking funny.
What else was I going to tell you?
Body.
Side note is that Switches are now like, my God, millions.
Really? You can actually have stock of Switches again?
I'm like, what am I going to do with all these Switches? Like, there's too many for the demand now. Reverse problem.
Reverse problem. Well, good for Nintendo that they actually got supply met.
We could actually lay away them. I was shocked at that.
That's
like,
awesome.
We're doing that, apparently.
It's good, too, because it's only $300.
Finally.
But
that's just everything. In time for Odyssey.
That's everything I have for Nintendo news. You heard it here first. Switches are now in stock again, guys. So if you're having trouble getting one, like that one guy from fucking Square Enix couldn't get one, call Charlie. Her phone number is blah, 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 blah.
Just email me.
Right.
Or Charlie's. Send us a letter. Like, we give you 5 million ways.
Send us a vial of Tweet your blood. Me. And we'll check it out.
Send $400 cash in the envelope to our P.O. box.
You need to get like 50 Target
unmarked
gift
bills,
cards
please.
With these amounts of the envelope.
Meet us in a Walmart parking lot. Right on. That's everything we have for Nintendo news. As far as additional news, I love this first article because we totally talked about this 2 weeks ago.
We're so topical.
We really are. We're on point with our content, guys. We're the greatest. PUBG, Player Unknown's Battlegrounds.
It's free to say.
Added in a bunch of fucking advertisements, and they're like Chinese in-game ads that are paid for, and people were super fucking pissed about it, and because of that, they decided to review Flame Them, and they got almost 10,000 negative reviews within 24 hours of this happening, which just goes to show that people will literally come out and just shit all over something if you fuck something up. And again, this goes against everything a review really is. It's one tiny piece of the game's content, and most of these people are people that have been playing the shit out of this game
for months and months, but now they're pissed.
Now there's one thing, and it's still in early access, but they're gonna go and fucking review bomb it, and which it's like, that's insane. 10,000 negative reviews.
Which is another thing to think about. That's
a lot of people.
That's another aspect of this, is that you risk, if you hurt your community that you already have, you risk that they will go and review it because they probably haven't yet. Like,
right.
Steam users don't buy games and then review them because they're not, like, normal. Well, they're not, like, that's not normal. I mean, that is normal. But, I mean, like, they're not cool people where they're like, yeah, you know what? This game's good. Let me review it. They wait until they get angry or something crazy happens and then they review it.
And Steam is smart enough to now have those metrics where it shows you by day when your dip happened. And this graph is just great because it shows you blue on the top, red on the bottom for positive versus negative reviews. And one day hits and all of a sudden it literally looks like it shit a brick because it's that color of red.
Oh my God.
And the 3 day total over it just keeps on growing for negative reviews. And the funniest thing is that the largest amount of positive reviews they had were on those same days. Because people knew this was happening and they tried to counteract it. And realistically, it's about every 5 reviews since this happened, 4 of them have been negative and 1 of them has been positive. So it's just like we're getting to a point now where we're going to eliminate the point of having reviews on these fucking sites. And it really worries me that people will go and like firebomb reviews on stuff like Amazon, where I just order products and I actually trust the reviews. Like, oh, 400 people have reviewed this. It's got 4.5 stars. But what happens if something goes wrong and they decide to make a political statement?
Like, you don't get your Nintendo Switch on time, and then they decide to go on there like, I wish I could review this, but I don't freaking have it.
Right.
You know, I have been hearing some weird Amazon stories lately, and I don't know if it's related to Amazon like themselves or if it's like third party and these people are just getting unlucky. But I've had like 2 or 3 things recently where people told me they ordered something from Amazon and got like the worst shit ever. Like, wow. One guy told me he ordered one of the new Minecraft, like, pig-looking controllers. And he was like, it was supposed to be brand new, and instead I got a pre-owned blue one. Like,
that makes no sense.
That's fucked up. I've heard, like, random stories like that lately. I don't know what is going on.
I'd be beating some ass.
Right, I'd be super upset. Like, I paid for this, so I want my product shipped to me now.
Yeah.
But that's bizarre.
I order so much from Amazon.
She really does. It's like she gets to unwrap a gift every day.
Yeah.
And her bank account dwindles and dwindles.
I haven't seen anything wrong yet, so.
Yeah, she'll be the first to let you know if there's something wrong with Amazon, so. Speaking of PUBG, however, we did report on last week's show that it looks like they're flirting with Sony to try and see what they are willing to do to make it not exclusive to Microsoft. And within days, we learned from Bloomberg sources that they are likely to offer Microsoft a longer console exclusivity period, with that period lasting, quote, until the middle of next year or longer.
Wow.
So it's like they came out of it and they said, like, I didn't like what I heard from Sony. Microsoft, we're going to give you an opportunity to make us stay on your console and only your console.
And we fucking called
it. That's really cool.
I know, dude. It was like, well, maybe Microsoft's going to go in there with a boatload of fucking money and be like, hey, guys, like, just keep it just on us. So it sounds like they got their number. They went to Microsoft and all of a sudden they're like, okay, we'll offer it to them, so.
I like to think that Sony just shit a brick. And
I think Sony realistically is like, we don't fucking need you.
Yeah.
I really think that's what happened.
Which I'm not saying is like a smart way to run your business, but I understand why they would feel like, we're not going to throw tons of money at you. We have a huge user base. Like, you should want to be on our platform.
Yeah.
The other thing that gets me is that they probably brought up crossplay, which I would imagine PlayStation is still against.
Yeah. It's a very good point. Man, if you could be a fly on those fucking walls, I'd love it. I cannot
believe PlayStation is the only company that's like, we don't want to share, sorry.
Believe it, sister. They're in the lead. They just want people to only be able to play with their friends. That way, if there's that one game that you want to play.
Stay in the lead.
I agree. But it's realistically, if you have that one game that you really want to play, excuse me, and you have to pick which system you're going to play it on, you want to play with your friends. And if they know their user base, the first time they've ever been able to say, like, people that want to play multiplayer games might actually want to play on Sony instead of Microsoft. Mm-hmm. So, but who knows? Next piece of news. Injustice 2's next DLC has been revealed. You can go and watch the trailer now. The next character to be added to the Injustice 2 rosters is the Atom. And it's Ryan.
It's you? You're going to be there?
Yeah, I'm in it. A-T-O-M.
Oh, I mean, Atom, it's even the same as your email, the Atom.
Yeah, it is kind of. Except, yeah, not really. But it's actually the Ryan Choi version of the Atom, not the one that you've seen in Arrow. I haven't seen it in Arrow. Yeah. He's not the greatest. It's Brandon Ruth who's playing him, so it's like him trying to redeem himself.
You've never seen Brandon Ruth in Arrow.
You know
yet?
It right away. Like, he creates the suit as soon as he gets on the show. But he will be your next character in Injustice 2.
I think my hopes for Spawn in Injustice are probably dead, which they never really had a reason to be there anyways, because no one has ever said that, but everyone wanted it.
I think it'll happen. Just
Todd McFarlane's stay strong. Rebooting that
maybe
movie.
Maybe Injustice 3.
And he's going to make it a hard R. I know. So maybe then we'll get the push for it.
I'm excited.
This next piece of news is actually really cool, and it's one of those things where the fan base is making me want to play their game. But we've talked about Elite Dangerous here and there on the show. There have been aliens within this
You're
persistent
pretty elite
world.
Dangerous.
Thank you. There's been aliens in this persistent world that have been, like, benevolent and just sort of, like, passive. And recently, the player base has been like, hey, they're attacking us now. Like, what the fuck's up with that? And they're like, I guess you're going to have to figure something out. So they had to figure out how to kill these aliens. And they're, like, massive aliens in space.
Oh.
And so, like, the entire player base has been like, this is actually really cool. It's clear that they put these things here so that we would get used to them. And then all of a sudden, they become an enemy. So they started figuring out tactics for defending themselves against these things. And earlier this week, a new patch dropped, and they took all the data that they had gathered from how players had been actually defeating the aliens, and now the aliens have new battle tactics and learned to defend against, like, the player strategies for the ways that they can be killed.
Dang.
And it's like, this is just a really cool way to just, like, not really say anything, but have your player base have some sort of evolving universe, and it's just one of those things where game developers who want to just have, like, a persistent world rather than just a straightforward release, it gives them that creative freedom to be like, let's fuck around now. Like, let's have fun with our players. And everyone's having fun. The number of concurrent users keeps going up. So
that's really cool.
If you play Elite Dangerous, please message us. Please email
Wade
us and let us know what the fuck's going on. Wade plays it. Awesome.
Yeah, Wade plays Elite Dangerous, and he calls it Spaceships.
Wow. Wade, you need to let us know what's going on with Elite Dangerous, bro.
Yeah.
Because this sounds fantastic.
I'll get up.
And one thing that I knew Robin would be super excited to hear, the Overwatch Halloween event for 2017 has had its date confirmed.
It's all the things
it'll
she
be
loves.
October 10th is when it begins. It'll run through November 2nd. They also shared a brief teaser video, if you want to go check that out, of
I
new Halloween themed skins for McCree and Reaper. And Reaper's was already, hang on, let me read this. The Ladder of Witch already had an excellent one from last year's event.
The Ladder of Witch, indubitably.
Yeah, so Reaper had a really good one last year, and now he's got a really good one this
year.
So
I
want
to see it.
It's because Reaper is awesome. So if you want to see it.
Well, what sucks is they're taking, like, the League of Legends approach, kind of, and, like, the characters that are better in the competitive world are getting all the kudos and all the skins, whereas the characters who aren't as good are getting left out. So I mean, it's a good approach because it's going to help.
It'll help.
It's obviously selling games, but at the end of the day, it's not, like, somebody who's, like, a real diehard fan of, like, Mercy, who has kind of fallen out of the competitive scene. They're not going to get another Mercy skin for 2 months, and that just kind of makes somebody sad when you see someone like Reaper who's got, like, 15, almost 20 plus different skins now.
Right.
I just love the tombstones with the hands sticking out of the graves.
Yeah,
that was a really cool. Isn't that the animation that happens at the end if you get play the game or whatever?
I think it's like a stance or a.
Yeah. What? No, the tombstones are a stance. Yeah. So basically, when you load into the game, or
that's how your character.
And it shows your team. Yeah, your character has a little stance that they're doing, and the Halloween ones from last year were a bunch of different ones of them, like, sticking their gun out of the ground, or you saw, like, Winston's helmet. There's a bunch of different things.
Yeah, I really like Halloween events from Blizzard. They've always been the coolest. It makes me want to get back on World of Warcraft and try and get that Headless Horseman mount. God damn it. I fucking ran that thing all the time to try and get it. Every year I played World of Warcraft, I never got it.
We have a lot of mounts in World of Warcraft.
We do. We got extra ones we now like that we are going to BlizzCon. Shit. We got Zeppelins and shit.
Too bad you guys won't play with me.
I like, keep trying.
Pay for my subscription and I'll play it.
All right, send us a Scroll of Resurrection.
Really?
Deal.
Oh, shit.
Now
I will buy both of you 3 months if you play.
Fuck yeah, dude. I'm in
too, Charlie.
Holy shit. I will stream Charlie so much Nerd Chills World of Warcraft.
No thanks.
Charlie's like, I will continue to have a successful social life and professional life.
Professional, maybe. Social, right. No.
That's funny. One last thing regarding Overwatch. Junkenstein's Revenge will be making a return. It is a specific game mode similar to
kind
the
of like,
Olympic Games.
Lucio.
Exactly. So go ahead and Lucio check that out when it comes out. And this last one I will let Charlie read since she dropped it in. And I know someone is going to be super excited to hear it.
Yeah, I bet they will. So, it has been announced that there is a Bob's Burgers movie in development.
I'm so excited.
My question is live action or is it like a cartoon feature length
film? No, it's a live action Bob's Burgers.
You could because you could just have H. John Benjamin, which would be awesome.
Would you have liked to watch the Simpsons movie live action?
Yeah,
no,
I would.
No, ew.
So now the not so hot news is that the targeted release date is July 17th of 2020.
Oh my God.
So hold on.
Right.
Robin and I will be 30 by then.
Oh, ouch.
And Adam will be probably dead. I don't know.
Yeah.
Oh, please don't say that.
Probably dead.
I will be 35.
I'll take care of you, girl.
No, you said January. Fuck you. To January of 2020?
July 17th.
July 17th, I will be 35.
Dang.
Robin will be 29.
I will still be in my 20s. Eat it, old people.
But they did say that the creator of the series has said that they want it to scratch every itch of the fans of the show have ever had.
It's creepy.
I'm itchy all the time, so.
He doesn't want to know where I itch.
While also still being appealing to people that are unfamiliar with the show.
Oh, that's cool.
Which I think opens the door for, like, a lot of these types of things. Like, it's been a long time, like, since Simpsons movie.
Right.
So maybe we'll get...
That was a long time ago.
Yeah, and they never made, really, like, a Family Guy movie, so maybe this will open the door again for these things. Maybe we can hope for a Rick and Morty movie.
Ooh, that'd be awesome.
Yes.
You never know.
By the way, guys, this Friday, which will be in the past by the time you hear this... make sure you go to McDonald's and
Szechuan sauce.
Only for dine-in guests you can get the Mulan Szechuan sauce that Rick has been trying to get for the last season. Because they love Rick and Morty, like they sent the guys that created Rick and Morty two gallons of Szechuan sauce.
But I mean, the guy that sent the Szechuan sauce wasn't McDonald's itself.
It's not true. Can't be.
Why would they say dine-in only? Like, I'd be like, now get the fuck out.
Because I think they just want people to come in so their stores can be packed.
Maybe.
So. You know how much money they're going to make off that?
Yeah, everyone at fucking work is already planning on who's going to drive and who's going to ride with who.
Wow.
I'm like, you guys are fucking crazy. I'll be in an airplane.
I want Szechuan sauce.
We're not flying back to Chicago to eat fucking McDonald's.
Charlie, get me some Szechuan sauce.
Okay.
Yay! Somebody loves me.
I hate you so much right now.
Oh, no. You're going to have to go. Have you seen what the little... containers look like?
Do they have Rick and Morty
on them? Okay, I have to
send
you this.
Describe it for our listeners.
They have a bunch of like Rick and Morty stuff all over them.
I guess we do have to go. I guess we can just split a 10-piece nugget or something.
No.
You guys might have better luck in like rural areas.
Because I mean,
that's true.
You got to think if you get your hand on one of those and just keep it.
No.
Ew. No. I'm sorry. That's nasty.
You're talking like a crazy person, CJ.
All right, I'll be crazy, and I'll make millions of dollars somehow.
I'm not judging you. I just don't know what Szechuan sauce tastes like, so I don't know if
just
I even want to keep
it. Get Szechuan sauce and sell it on eBay right away for like 20, 30 bucks a pop.
Do you really think people will buy Szechuan sauce for 20, 30 bucks?
I mean, come on.
Okay, then we'll go in there, and we'll be like, hey, give me a stock box. I'll bring my gun. Like, give me a stock box, or I'll blow your fucking brains out.
Wow.
I'm sure that'll work. Right on. So that's the news that we have for you. We're going to move right into our main topic of what we would pick.
Oh, that wasn't it, Szechuan sauce?
No. Of what we would pick as game of the year if the year ended right now on October 4th, you know, before all the big titles came out.
We like to live like we're, like it's our last day.
Exactly.
Yeah.
If the world ended in 13
like
days.
Something traumatic happened and I had a flash of my whole life and I was like, game of the year this year.
Right. You know, the worst part about the whole Vegas shooting is the people that are completely full of shit that are looking for attention or sympathy. Like, I fucking heard this lady on the radio who called in. She was like, I was at the Mandalay like 16 days ago. That could have been me.
No.
And it's like, maybe some people actually think like that. But I was like, you know what? I work a mile from the Mandalay every fucking day, you dumb twat. I was so annoyed.
I can beat that.
Please do.
One of my coworkers also works at a bank, and they said that someone on Monday said that they should waive a fee because the tragedy happened.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
And it wasn't like I was there or I couldn't make my payment because of this or blah, blah, or I'm really in dire straits. It was just like, you should just do it because that happened.
That's horrible.
Any of those people listen to this podcast, you are a piece of human garbage, yeah. And I hate you. That is unbelievable. So, speaking of games of the year, CJ, we're gonna start with you this time. If the year ended today, what would be your game of the year?
It's got to be Overwatch, right?
Right?
Yes. Again, still gonna that's my game that of the year. Overwatch. Can I make that game of the year again?
I hate you.
The game.
It won game of the year 55 different times in 2016. The Overwatch
Anniversary Edition is my game of the year choice.
Oh yeah, technically a new version of the game came out.
The Overwatch Game of the Year Edition.
That's so fucking funny. Right on. Charlie, if you had to stop right now, I mean, if you had to stop, collaborate, and listen, what would the game of the year be?
Well, you know, I honestly don't have an answer, so I think I'm just going to Kaiser Soze this off my lanyard. Oh, wait, my lanyard says Horizon Zero Dawn.
I hate you so much. Did Kaiser Soze have a lanyard? Is that how that ending worked?
I don't know. You know what I mean? Like, Kaiser Soze.
Oh, spoilers, guys.
Kaiser Sozeing it is like just, you know, seeing the first thing and saying it.
Ah, yeah.
So
okay,
the first thing I saw, it also was the best game this year.
I just dropped my coffee mug that said Kobayashi on the bottom of it. I'm like, what?
Yeah, it would definitely be Horizon. I haven't finished that game yet, admittedly. You know what? I did beat a game this year. I beat Sexy Brutale. That's not game of the year contender, though. I did this twice.
That scared the shit out of me that time, though.
So, yeah, it would definitely be Horizon.
Right on. Robin, if you had to pick a game from 2017 to be 2017 game of the
Overwatch
year in 2017.
Game of the year.
I know that's the thing that you've played the absolute most, aside from Fallout
4. Fallout 4 again.
And Fallout Shelter, because you live in last year. Because 2016 was such a great year, you can't leave it behind. But is there anything in particular that's come out this year?
Wait. Hold on. I got it. Settlers of Catan.
Oh, my God.
Hey, all games are games. That's all I'm saying. But it didn't come out this year. It's like saying Overwatch. It came out in, like, 1994. I looked it up.
That's what's good about it.
Can I say Breath of the Wild?
You can if you want.
I think
you watched me play, like, 40 hours of it.
Yeah, I think that should be a game of the year.
Don't you want to wait until you watch him play Horizon?
Oh, yeah.
You can change your mind when we talk about Game of the Year next. Anyways, so my Game of the Year, it has to be Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Just because literally every way you play that game, you can go back and play it through completely differently. You can choose how you want to end your game. Like it's like a choose-your-own-adventure Zelda game. Like from start to finish, and if you want to do 100% completion, you're literally looking at like 500 to 600 hours. That's before the DLC. And the DLC is nice enough to track your movement for the last 200 hours, which is just bizarre. Because just looking at the map and seeing everywhere that you've walked the entire time you've played the game is like, you realize, wow, I've never gone there. I'm going to go to that area. And then you realize, I missed an entire giant section of this fucking map. And it like opens up new parts of the world. But for me, it'd have to be Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Just because, I mean, everyone says, like, you can climb everything. And yes, you can, but realistically, when you open up a map vertically like that, it does change your perspective on just about everything. So, it's just, it was a game changer. I don't think I can play many other Zelda games and look at them again the way I looked at Breath of the Wild.
I have a question.
Sure.
When is the last time Nintendo won a Game of the Year?
Probably the last,
Skyward Sword? No.
No. Skyward Sword didn't do as, it did really well critically. But not commercially, so I don't think it got picked for Game of the Year.
I gotta look that up, because I bet it's been a long time. And they make great games, but like,
right.
I bet it's been a long time.
It was probably Twilight Princess.
It's looking pretty old here. It's looking 64 old.
Ocarina of Time?
Ocarina and GoldenEye.
Whoa.
Yeah, so it would be good for them. Good for them.
Yeah, good for Nintendo to make, you know, one of the greatest games of all time.
Yeah. I mean, but South Park is not out yet, you guys.
It's not out till next year, though, so.
South Park?
Isn't it?
No, it's in like a week. It's October 17th. I thought I read
like an hour ago that it got pushed till March.
Are you serious?
I'm just fucking with you.
I will stab you.
I just want to see your face. That's November, right? November 17th.
October 17th.
October 17th?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. My schedule just cleared up, so. Right on.
Same day as Gran Turismo, so you're going to have to choose, you know.
Fuck Gran Turismo. It's hard. Like, I hate that game. Sorry.
Yeah.
Awesome. We'll see what changes between now and I hate you. But we'll see what changes between now and the end of the year when all these big titles. I really think that my dark horse for Game of the Year for games that hasn't come out yet is Battlefront 2. Because if that story is really good, the fact that the story is canon and all the multiplayer, because Zelda doesn't have any multiplayer, can make Call that game of keep Duty. Playing. Just so, kidding. I'm really excited for it.
Yeah, Odyssey.
We will see what happens.
I don't know. I feel like Odyssey's not going to be different enough.
I'm not a big Mario guy, but...
I know, you're maybe. Not into it.
I don't know, but that's what we have picked so far this year. Robin, even though she hasn't played it, went with Breath of the Wild, as did I. Charlie went with Horizon Zero Dawn. CJ went with PUBG. So we'll see if those hold up come January. But that's the show that we got for you guys. I know it's kind of short.
I think that we could probably do, when it gets like end of the year, another one where we talk about the actual categories. Because, of course, there's like best shooter, best RPG, best multiplayer.
Yeah.
And so I think that would be cool to go more in depth. And that would give us a little bit more time to decide on every category, since Robin couldn't even come up with one.
And I think we should really do a best mobile game, because we do highly encourage mobile games. I know we've kind of been shitty about the Cell Phone Game Book Club for the last couple months, but... being that, you know, we've kind of championed the fact that everyone plays games and they take dumps, we definitely need to pick one. So.
That's why we all have Switches.
Yeah, and that episode, too, we will not have news. It'll just be us going through the categories and picking one.
Can we dress up really fancy?
Sure. I'll wear a fucking bow tie.
Can we be like, can we play the music like, da 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 da?
We might not be able to hear it, but I'll play it all on the episode.
Can we just all hum it?
Sure. That works. So...
cool.
Right on. I think that's everything we have for you guys for Midlife Crisis episode 40. Thank you for listening. We do appreciate everything that you guys do for us. Please remember that if you share the show with a friend, it really, 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 really helps. If you see us posting it on Facebook or Twitter, go ahead and share that as well and just say like, hey, this is something I enjoy. You guys should listen to it too. Because that's great for us. Or if you want to drop us a review on iTunes or any of the other sites in which you download, that also really helps us. If you want to go ahead and kick us anything, go to our Patreon. It is NerdChills on patreon.com. And if you pay $3, you do get early access to the show by at least 24 hours. We've been really good about that for like the last 10 episodes. And I don't see it slopping anytime. And then we're going to get some better goals for you guys at the $10 and $20 range.
Slopping, so, huh?
Stopping. but if you want to go ahead and email the show, you can email nerdchills at nerdchills.net. You can tweet at us at nerd_chills. You can tweet at me at the Adam Diaz or email me maylum at nerdchills.net. If I stream, which I never do, it'll be twitch.tv/maylum, M-A-Y-L-U-M, yet again. I think that's just about it. You can check us out on facebook.com/nerdchillspodcast at our Facebook page, which is not a group. And Charlie, where can the fine folks find you?
Other than right here, you guys can find me on Twitter. My handle is charlie_NC is in nerdchills. And you can also email me, charlie@nerdchills.net.
And it's Charlie with an E-Y, the real way to spell it, not the freak way. Unless any of our listeners out there who like to share a spell with an IE, in which case we accept all Charlies. Robin, where can the fine folks find you?
Yeah, you can find me on all social media, for the most part, at the Robin Grace.
Right on. And where can they find your Etsy shop?
Oh, robinskawaiicorner.etsy.com.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Thank you guys one more time for listening. One last huge shout out to our Vegas fans. We love you guys to death. Thank you guys for stopping by and listening to us. So take a chill pill, people. We'll see you next week.
See you.